Hello.
Hi. Hi, guys. Today we're gonna celebrate the influence of the US on Norway. And first of all, we have to say congratulations with an election. And to all of you who are happy, hey, hey.
Hooray.
And to all of you who are sad, well, there will be a next time within 4 years. The US has been a major influencer on Norwegian culture.
Oh, Norway is influenced by the USSR.
No, mostly from... No, absolutely not. We are influenced by the US. Since the World War II, your culture, your way of living has been flushing upon us here in Norway. And the first thing and the most important thing, I think, from the US that came to Norway and that is still very popular, it's actually one of the most read magazines still in Norway 50 years after it was launched. And that's Donald Duck.
Oh, Donald! I love him.
He is an American sweetheart in Norway. We just love Donald Duck. And Mats, is this your passion?
This is my passion. I know everything about Karl Barks and yeah, he's a real Donaldist.
Yeah, so we are not so keen on Mickey or Minnie or the other...
It's not Mickey, it's Mickey, your moron.
Mickey, yeah, well, we are not that into Goofy or them. The one that we love in Norway is Donald Duck. When I was a kid, they called me Ronald Donald Duck.
And that was not a pleasant
note. No, because it came Ronald Donald Duck, liten og tjukk. That means Ronald Donald Duck, little fatty, actually. But that was it. But Donald, he is a thing that we love from the US.
Who are you in Donald? Dolly?
No, I wouldn't say Dolly, would I? I'm not sure. I have to think about
Grandma Duck. Grandma Duck.
Yeah. And the biggest star, and he's an old guy from the US. Can you guess? Try to guess. Who is the biggest American music pop star, whatever, in Norway?
Versace?
What? No.
Liberace?
It's not Liberace. It's not Madonna. The biggest star of them all is Bruce Springsteen.
Streets of Philadelphia.
You know what? He can come whenever he wants to Norway, and there is no artist in the world that will get as huge as a crowd as Bruce Springsteen still.
Even if he's like 150 years old.
Yeah, well, we don't care. And we call him a friend of Norway or a Norges venn. And if you have
that's a saying.
Yeah, if you have that, if you have that label, you are huge in Norway. So Bruce Springsteen, huge guy. And when it comes to food and beverage, there's one thing that you guys in the US have produced, and that is I would call it the water of life.
A Budweiser.
No, it's not a Budweiser. This is like in most, there's no country in the world that consumes as much of this per capita.
Oh, Falkencrest,
the wines.
Falkencrest wines.
No, and it's not Coca-Cola because it is Pepsi Max. Pepsi Max is like the biggest, this is the most sold beverage in Norway, and we are. You can constantly hear on radio, television, and read about it how Norwegians have become addicted.
Is it healthy?
Well, healthy, I'm not sure, but it's no sugar in it, and that people need.
We like to believe it's healthy.
Yeah, but Norwegian needs to be treated for their Pepsi Max addiction, actually. It's a thing in Norway.
I have to reveal a little secret. What's Ronald's favorite drink? It's vodka
with Pepsi Max. It's not only Ronald's favorite, is it, Mats?
No, we have the spray. Yeah. They call it a mix.
So when we are out, we have vodka Pepsi Max. So I am I'm a true Pepsi Max addicted person, actually. I wonder if I need to go to rehab. Okay. We in Your Way to Norway, we try to combine education with humor and fun.
No.
Yes, we are. Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
You think so, yeah.
And one of the biggest influencers when it comes to humor, comedy, and that has really created our new Norwegian humor.
Jim Carrey.
Well, he is popular in Norway too, but it's not him. There's another one.
Jimmy Fallon.
No, not Jimmy Fallon, not Stephen Colbert, and not Seth Meyers, not, no, we are not talking
Everyone loves Lucy.
Lucy Ball?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm not that old, even though I am old, and the references that you will have here, it's a bit old. Jerry Seinfeld. Jerry Seinfeld is actually, I would say, the godfather of Norwegian comedy right now.
Why?
I'm not sure. It's his practical kind of sarcasm,
dry,
irony,
dry,
very
humor.
Dry, yeah, and very direct in a way.
Self-ironic.
Self-deprecation.
That word.
That word, yeah. And still, I would say that all our young comedy talents are very inspired by him. So Jerry
Not
Seinfeld,
only inspired, they are trying to be like him.
It's hard, and they really seldom succeed. But that's another story, actually.
And who are you in Seinfeld?
Seinfeld.
I think you maybe are Elaine. Elaine Venus. Yeah, that's you.
Yeah.
But who am I?
George Costanza? Yes, you are.
No.
Yeah. No. Mats is George Costanza. Oh, okay. Grumpy George is Grumpy Mats. Oh, sorry, Mats. Yeah. But I am Elaine. Yeah. And who are you in the Seinfeld show?
Yeah, it's a lot of psychology
George,
into that.
Are you Elaine? Are you Kramer? Who are you?
Or in Friends.
Yeah, but Friends wasn't that. No. Friends is big, but. No, it was Jerry Seinfeld's show. That's still on.
The show about nothing.
Yeah. Television is from US is big. And there was this one show that really revolutionized Norway. It took Norway from old peasant, Lutheran, frugal, to think bigger, to think more like glamour. No. There was this show, and this is a 1980s reference that still really is that I think it must have been the most watched show, the US show in Norway.
Oh, the streets were empty. Every Wednesday, the streets were empty.
It was on every Wednesday in the night, and the bars were closed, everything was closed, because nobody went out, everyone was in front of the television.
It was a daily in the
US. And one of the starring roles, she was from Norway, and my God, we were proud, can you guess it?
She had a Norwegian friend.
Yeah, she had Norwegian relatives, I think, and we were dead proud. As I told you, it revolutionized Norway. Can you guess it?
It was about big luxury.
The intro was like, there were different and it was a big house, and it was luxury.
Is it Dallas?
No, it's not Dallas. And it's not Falcon's Crest. It was Dynasty! And Crystal Jennings! Can you remember her?
I want to sing that song!
Young guys, I'm so sorry for this really, really old reference, but Dynasty with Crystal Jennings, she was from Norway, and Alexis, that bad
bitch.
And they were fighting. Yeah.
And ended up in the pool.
And
what happened with Crystal? She was locked up.
Yeah, we ended, the interest ended when she was locked up in an attic, and she was sitting there for, I don't know, several months. Then the interest faded. But I think Dynasty really was a groundbreaking show that really transformed Norway and the way we are thinking.
Were you going to your bar?
And some of you guys have posted comments and asked, why in the beep's name are you that interested in our election? And this is a really, really important thing to understand. We are a very small country. We are bordering with USSR. So for us, and I'm not sure if this is a totally US thing, but it's a collaboration. And the NATO, you know, NATO is a key word here. That's why we are deadly interested in who's going to be the next president of the US and what does this person mean or think about NATO.
Aren't we occupied about Putin?
Yeah, well, we are a bit afraid of Putin, so when you guys have a president that are not that interested in NATO, Norwegians are becoming leaves like this and falling of frightenedness and oh no! And now we are wondering if your new president might be a little bit more interested in keeping NATO together. But we were talking about Norgesvenn.
And Norwegian friend.
Yeah, Norwegian, friend of Norway, I would call it, I think. A friend of Norway or a Norgesvenn is a person that really express their love for Norway. We're such a small country with such low esteem. So when, for instance, a US star comes around and say, and this woman from the US, she married a Norwegian, she was a big star. And she was a music star. And she married a Norwegian. She came with all her glamour to Norway on the stage. And she said in broken Norwegian, "Jeg elsker dere." I love you guys. Can you guess who this Norwegian friend? She had big hair. And she had a beautiful voice. And she was glamorous. She is still glamorous.
I know. Who? I think she is dancing a bit, yeah.
I think they dance like this on their stage.
But she chose like a very sporty man, you know.
Yeah. A mountain climber and a family of mountain climbers. Her name was, and she's big in Norway, Diana Ross.
Shh. Copyright ban.
What? But it's not her song. Okay. Oh, no, relax. It's just,
this is your verse.
This is her way of...
Okay, have a dance. Have a little Diana Ross dance. We have to see some glitter here now.
A real Norgesvenn. Norway, and you have this pot-smoking visionary pioneer in in the US, and pot-smoking is not allowed in Norway.
Yeah, for medical reasons it is.
But really it's not, I would say it's really not allowed in Norway. But this guy, your guy, he seems to love it. He seems to love music, he seems to love space.
And he likes to name his children very strange names.
Yeah, that I have to give him credit for. What was it? XIYU2 Bay?
Oh, you reveal him already, no. You're a moron.
Norway, of course, and this is a modern reference, we are totally crazy in love with Tesla cars because Norway wants to be the world's most best when it comes to climate change, sustainability, and what is the key to
this? New energy.
Yeah, it's Tesla. Toyota go home, Volkswagen go home, Mercedes go home, Tesla. Please come inside. These are Norwegian references, US influence on Norway. You that lives in Australia or in India or China or in Africa or wherever outside of US, what is the most American thing that influenced your culture, your country?
Yeah, post it, leave us a comment, we're dying to know. Subscribe and push a bell and become a part of our community.
We want to hear, absolutely. We have this Norwegian that thinks he is an American.
What?
Yeah, and I think he was living in Los Angeles.
You shouldn't think you are anything.
He is really, really non-Norwegian.
He's like a self-built man.
Yeah, the American dream. He went to Los Angeles, I think. He became a model, a porn actor, and a hairdresser, and a stylist, soft porn or something like that, I've read. And then he came back and his name is Jan Thomas. And he's really a totally ordinary Norwegian, but he went out there west to Los Angeles, Hollywood, and he came back and now he's preaching and teaching Norway how to become real American. Self-confident Americans.
How to bleach your teeth.
How to brag.
How to bleach your teeth.
Yes.
And do your surgical stuff.
Yeah. Well. And how to look the best. And like, so he is.
In the beginning, it was like, who the hell is this?
Yeah.
And now we are actually like loving this guy.
But he's in all. He's on in all medias. He records songs. And he has no voice, but as an American, he believes in himself and is very confident. I think that was it. That was American influence on Norway. And I hope you appreciated it. You know, we have like almost 100 educational funny videos about Norway. If you are bored, if you are back again in quarantine or whatever, well, don't hesitate.